Afternoon 2K Sports Edition of the NBA. Alongside Doris Burke and Greg Anthony, this is Kevin Harlan. And on the sidelines, Hall of Famer David Aldridge. Let's check out the Eastern Conference standings now that we're in the new year. Taking a look at Boston, they're looking extremely sharp right now, poised in the top spot and playing very well. And of course, Indiana, 9 games back.
And you know, for the Celtics, they had a few critics coming into the season, and now I don't think they have any. This is a club ready to not only make a deep run, but possibly win it all.
Well, this is their goal. There's no doubt about that. For what many expected of them so far, they have not disappointed.
Let's check out Indiana's starting lineup. They've got Siakam. Tyrese Haliburton is out there with Heal. And there's Miles Turner. And it's Nesmith in at the 3 slot. And for the Celtics, the wing pairing, it's White and Brown. Tatum out there with Porzingis, and it's Holiday in at the point. You know, with all the talent in these two backcourts, Doris, this should be a very exciting matchup.
And you know, Kev, it feels like we could say that for most matchups these days, right? The league is so heavily laden with talent at the guard position. I feel spoiled.
Now here's Heald. Turner passes to Haliburton. That falls. Nice feed that time from Turner.
Yeah, give Haliburton credit for staying with the play. You've got to be able to fend off that defense and still finish.
Porzingis with a screen on Siakam. Leans from outside. A nice shot by Tatum.
And he's showing us a little bit of everything now. Taking a leaner with still one on him.
Holiday against Haliburton. Pass to Nesmith. Heald left side. Stolen by Holiday. White with it. Now guarded by Heald. Here's Brown. And he banks in the layup.
Well, I'll tell you what, speaks to the toughness of Jaylen Brown. That frame is strong.
And here's Haliburton. He'll bring it up for the Pacers. They come into this having outplayed Phoenix the last game.
Yeah, they took advantage of some porous defense in that one. Really got the shots they wanted.
Give them some credit. I'll tell you this. They caught an opponent on a very off night defensively, and you take advantage. Simple as that.
Tatum against Siakam. Takes the 13-footer. Tatum, no good.
Well, that's a blown defensive coverage, but it doesn't matter. He cannot answer the bell.
No doubt, Craig, Jason Tatum is an all-NBA player, and this guy continues to improve.
And JT's scoring average increasing in each of his first 5 seasons. I just love how he gets to the line more, being more aggressive. Tatum was the guy on a finals team at just 24 years old.
Heald against White, and stolen by White. He feeds it to Brown.
You have to admire the growth of Jaylen Brown. He comes in as an attacking athlete. He's now a better passer, and he absolutely is a knockdown three-point shooter.
Doris, looking at the career of Jaylen Brown so far, his rise to stardom has been impressive.
It's impressive, Kevin, because of the work put in. He needed to become a more complete offensive player by, number one, improving his handle, and number two, becoming more efficient with his shooting. He's done both. He's always been a force in transition. Jaylen has been special.
Greg, in terms of the Pacers' last few seasons, some have pointed to their relative lack of size. What do you think?
Well, I think a big push for them this summer was adding to their front court, particularly getting more size at the forward positions. And I think they've improved in that regard.
And Brown drops them both. Doris, we've talked about Boston's young talent for so long, they've now become battle-tested veterans.
And it's incredible how young that experience has taken hold. They have had players build big roles in so many big games. What a strong foundation, and now you've just got to keep building.
Siakam misses. The Celtics have gone 2-for-4 from the field so far today. Haliburton with the steal. Inside, shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws. It goes on Jason Tatum.
Well, with that 6'9" length, right, Siakam uses those long limbs to create contact, get himself some free throws. Nicely done.
Throw good, Siakam. You know what you love seeing from Pascal Siakam is his confidence continuing to grow.
And Kevin, especially when it comes to scoring. Pascal understands how valuable he is to his team and how much they lean on him to step up on that end.
Siakam hits them both. Here is something, Greg, from Pacers history. They were a dynasty at one point, and you remember it well.
Yeah, you're talking about the ABA days, but it's true. The Pacers were a dominant team before the merger. They won 3 titles in 4 seasons just before joining the league.
He's not always assertive on the catch, but Derek White, rise and fire from 3-point, and it is on target.
Pacers trail by 3. About 3 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Nesmith, the pass to Halliburton. Shot by Heel, nobody around, and once again off the mark by Indiana. For Boston, they've gone 3 of 5 shooting the ball so far. Porzingis sets the pick for Brown. Drives to the hoop, and he drops in the layup off the glass. Brown's got 6.
Boy, the quickness of Jaylen Brown on the drive. He makes it happen in an instant.
Indiana's gone 0-2 from deep here. Pass to Turner. Halliburton against Holiday. Pass to Nesmith. Traps in the tray.
And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
And here's Tatum. He'll bring it up for the Boston Celtics. Last game matched up with the Clippers. A tough loss there.
Well, they made a few key shots, but missed many more. It was a rough night for them offensively.
You know what? There was a lot of standing around in that basketball game. Failing to move bodies and failing to move the basketball is a bad formula.
Now White, following Drew Holiday's 3-point attempt. White finds Tatum. Hands it from downtown. 5 points in the game.
Well, if you leave someone that wide open, Derek White will put it on time and on target.
Heeled outside. Nesmith, the pass to Halliburton. And here is Nesmith. Turner with a screen on Tatum. And he's good on the 3 ball.
Boy, Pascal Siakam with the big time answer from 3. Nice.
The Celtics have gone 5 of 8 from the field, shooting over 62%. Holiday, the pass to Brown. Now Tatum, there's the 3. The shot's good. Brown making the play.
And he's really been working to get those looks, and it's starting to pay off here early on.
Halliburton against Holiday. Turner with a screen on Holiday. Heeled from outside.
Well, Brown taking away the shooter's airspace, effectively crowd scores and gets them out of their comfort zone.
The basket's coming early and often in the first quarter. Celtics lead by 5. And we'll be back shortly for the start of the second quarter. And if you're just joining us, we've played through 1 quarter in this one. And let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for Boston.
They've looked to fire as much as possible from outside the arc, and so far, they are hitting at a high clip.
And the other thing I love, how they're making the extra pass. They're not settling for the first shot. They're going from good to great.
There are many ways to build a team as we know, Doris. Do you prefer building around a star or a more team-based approach?
I think, Kevin, what we have learned unequivocally is that it is not just about collecting talent. Certainly, you need star players to win in the NBA. But so much of this is about how do the pieces fit around. There is a reason it is a team sport, Kevin. Don't overlook the role players around those stars.
On the court for Indiana, Jackson is out there with Toppin. Then there's Tyrese Halliburton. Then there's Benedict Mathurin. And it's Nembhard in at the shooting guard. And here is Tatum. After Tyrese Halliburton was able to get the triple, Banton's shot is off. Indiana trailing here. Time now to turn to our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Well, of course, the Pacers have a great history. And star point guard Tyrese Halliburton is eager to embrace it. He said, I want to know all the stories of Pacers players of the past. I want to know more about Ron Artest and everybody who played for this organization. I'm being where my feet are. I love being here in Indy. Kevin?
Oh, I'd love to hear that. He could be that next Pacers great player. David, thanks.
Mathurin, one of those guys who wants to deliver as many blows as he absorbs, draws the foul there.
And Doris, you watch the defenses try to corral Benedict Mathurin. He always seems to have an answer, doesn't he?
He does, Kevin. This guy knocks down jumpers in a variety of ways, whether it's off the bounce, catch-and-shoot situations. His mechanics are clean, he's confident, and boy, he is aggressive.
Boston making a switch here. Makai Lucas checked in. In the 2016 and 17 drafts, GA, Boston ended up with the third pick overall both of those years.
And they nailed those picks, getting Jaylen Brown and Jason Tatum back-to-back, setting up their franchise for years.
Boy, he won't miss many from that spot. The defense gets lucky there.
And we're a little over a minute and a half into the second quarter of action. Jackson kicks to Halliburton. Clock at six. Halliburton on the wing. Mathurin for three. That one's off. He's now 1-for-2. Boston's gone 3-of-7 tonight from three-point territory. Here's Mikhailu. Here's Pritchard. Tapping covering. A shot by Pritchard. No good. Indiana's gone 1-of-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. Halliburton feeling it out a bit. That doesn't go in. Had a chance, though, to take the lead. We're just over 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. Here's Pritchard. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against the Clippers. Outside Mathurin. Now the pass to Nembhard. The dish now to Jackson. Pass to Halliburton. Over in the corner, Mathurin. Beat the shot clock, but it's off the mark. For Boston, they've gone 1-of-6 from the field in the second quarter. It's been a rough period so far. Hauser misses.
And even without that three ball dropping for him, the defense should have done more on that last play.
Mathurin passes to Nembhard. Halliburton with it. The shot is good, and so is his shooting tonight. 3-for-4.
Well, you have to understand how to score when you're in the paint and you are 6'5". Tyrese Halliburton, he knows the way.
And now, the first timeout called here for Boston. So Indiana ends up with a new group on the floor. Now a chance to take a look at some numbers for Derek White.
And he's struggling with his shot these days, and the analytics bear that out with the true shooting percentage heading down in these past 10 games. But guys, it wouldn't surprise me if that was a trend that he could reverse here tonight.
.121 left now here in the second. Here's Holiday, and a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here.
Yeah, credit Holiday for getting to the line on that one. With his quickness and length, I'd like to see him do that more often.
And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. Scoring breakdown for the Pacers.
I like how they've worked the ball inside, getting looks closer in there, and that really helps your offense.
Well, also, guys, what a start from beyond the arc. A huge part of their game today. That's going to help their spacing.
And he makes the first. Both free throws good from Drew Holiday. And so it's McConnell with it. He'll bring it up for the Pacers. Their defense has only allowed 4 points in the quarter. Pass to Nesmith. Back to Siakam. Six to shoot. Fires from deep. Rebounded by the Celtics. The Pacers beat them last time when these two teams met in Indiana.
Hey, they had their opportunities, but let's face it, they choked from the line. Hard to win that way on the road.
You've got to stand in and deliver from the free throw line, even in a tough environment, and they failed to do so.
Now, here's Nesmith after Jaylen Brown's miss. They kick out to heel. Over to the left wing. A nice shot by Nesmith. Nesmith has got the lead up to two now for the Pacers.
Well, this guy has made giant strides in his playmaking. Nice setup by Buddy Hield right there.
Boston's got nothing but zeros from long range in the second quarter. 0-4. Brown feeling it out a bit. Porzingis sets the pick for Brown. And they call the foul, so a chance at the line for one more coming up.
How about the strength on the finish? Jaylen Brown showing real muscle.
Austin shooting their fifth attempt at the line in the game.
Mind the lane. Mind the lane. One shot.
A miracle. Are you kidding me?
Listen, under duress of the end of the period, you just throw it up and hope.
So that'll be it for the first half. Fairly even battle underway in this one. Pacers out in front. They lead by two. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks, Kevin. Rick, what's your analysis of how your defense has done so far?
Well, they're getting too many open looks at threes. We're lucky they're missing a few. You know, this team, they stretch out so much, you got to be really alert. You got to pay close attention to the details.
Rick, thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks so much, Dave, for the great interview. Don't go away, folks. We'll be back for the second half of basketball right after this.
Hello there, everybody. It's halftime, and right now the Indiana Pacers are in the midst of a good battle.
I know what Shaq's going to say. Elbow sandwiches. Those guys are physical, and they've controlled the glass. They gave the impression that they wanted it more, Shaq.
To be honest, all I heard was sandwiches. When's the food getting here?
And since we have a moment, let's see what other games are coming up tonight. The Hawks playing at State Farm Arena as they go up against the Raptors. That gets going at 6 p.m. Eastern.
These are solid teams, pretty close talent-wise.
Absolutely a sneaky good game that should be very entertaining.
And that about wraps it up. And as the third quarter is about to begin, we go to Kevin Harlan for the call.
And we're halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been fairly even so far. You look at Jaylen Brown, what a contribution.
Yeah, and just look at the numbers from the first half. He has been very efficient.
I think they've taken their time. They've showed incredible patience. It's a sign of a well-coached ball club.
The wing pairing, it's White and Brown. Porzingis is out there with Jason Tatum. And it's Holiday in at the one. And that's the group for Joe Mazzulla as we begin the second half. Here's Porzingis. The shot's good. Brown making the play. Porzingis has got it all tied up now for Boston.
There's simply no defense for that. Porzingis, so creative, can score in so many ways.
And you talk about a tough matchup, Doris, for teams against this one. Kristaps Porzingis. He is a tough cover.
Yeah, listen, Kev, this guy has that rare combination of both size and skill, increasingly more efficient, and when he's healthy, he's really been a problem.
Heald can't hit.
Pressured that shot by getting a hand up just as good as a block.
And he did it without fouling, and that's become an art, changing shots without making contact.
Such a wide open look. And now it's a three-point Boston lead.
Jaylen Brown gets his feet set in the catch and shoot and just drills it.
And with a little over a minute gone, the second half is underway. Heald against White. Heald outside. It's up a three. Sinks the three-pointer. Heald's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball.
Defensively, they just look out of sync, not closing out on the threes in time.
Outside Tatum. Over Siakam. And it hung on the rim, but wouldn't fall for him. Nesmith, the pass to Siakam. Kicks it to Heald. Passes it to Halliburton. Siakam outside. Down to five on the shot clock. Elbow shot. Basket counts. Siakam's got the lead up to two now for the Pacers.
Just focusing on the task at hand. That's all you can do.
Boy, the tide is running one way and then shifts back in the other direction. I've lost count of how many lead changes we've had here tonight. Boy, everyone is getting to their spots and then capitalizing. 3 for 4 in the quarter. Beautiful.
Not quite 2.5 minutes played here in the second half. Tatum against Siakam. Turner with a screen on Tatum. Siakam's shot is off.
Well, the defense flat out awful right there, and he couldn't punish them for their mistake. I'll tell you, it has not been this guy's best night, but the teammates have been there to pick up the slack. Love it.
Holiday against Halliburton. Out to Turner. Just 4 to shoot. Tries it from the top of the key. Heald can't hit. For Boston, they've gone 3 of 5 to start the second half, developing a nice rhythm out there. Outside, White. Back to Tatum. on the three off target. And so it's Halliburton who brings up the ball for Indiana. It's a one-point game. Next up on the schedule, the Grizzlies. That'll be a home game. That game will be a quick pit stop before hitting the road again. Shots good by Turner.
You can see how comfortable Miles Turner is on the interior. He knows he has the size and length to dominate.
Just over 3.5 minutes through the third quarter of play now. And now we've got some time to check in from the sideline. You got for us, D.A.?
Thank you, Kevin. The Pacers are a team on the rise, and their point guard, Tyrese Halliburton, has a lot to do with that. Coach Rick Carlisle said his will to win is spectacular for a young player. He's the motor, the engine who drives our team. When people look and say we're fun to watch, he's the head of the snake. He sets the tone for that in a big way. Kevin?
In a big way. High praise. Hey, David, thank you. So, timeout called here, the first for Indiana.
And with a moment, let's check out the stats for McConnell. How his last 10 games have gone. He's averaging 8 points, 6 assists, and 2 rebounds. I mean, the numbers aren't bad on their own, but he knows that he can help this team in a bigger way.
And sometimes it comes down to the flow of the offense. One night it's your night, another night, perhaps it's somebody else's.
One 11 left in the third. Siakam left side. And Pritchard pulls it down.
You know what? Just a little fancy on that possession there. Just go up in rhythm.
And there's the pass to Brown. Lock at 6. The Celtics working the ball around now. And the basket by Hauser.
That is such a tough matchup for smaller defenders out there. He can simply shoot right over them.
Bounce pass from McConnell. Here's Toppin. And once again off the mark by Indiana. Celtics leading by 4. 5-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Here's Pritchard. Nothing on the board. Horford's shot is good.
Well, that's just about sheer effort from Al Horford. The defense made their presence felt, but Horford utilizes his length.
To the inside, Siakam. And he makes the bucket, gets the whistle, and now a 3-point play chance here for him.
And that's an example of playing big, adapting to the situation.
Well, major height disadvantage. He recognizes that and still able to score it.
What's up?
Throw good, Siakam.
Boy, the evolution of Pascal Siakam has been such a pleasure to watch. The work ethic is commendable, and he's learning how to be a leader, guys.
We're at the end of the third, and we've still got a close one. Celtics lead by three. And do not go away, as we'll be back in just a few moments with the start of our fourth quarter coming up next. And a quick look now at the State Farm assist of the game.
Just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about the perfect delivery?
We call that putting it right in the pocket, and he knew what to do with it once it was there.
And it's been a very competitive game so far as we get rolling here in quarter number four. Pacers trail by three. And a look at the five for the Pacers to start the fourth quarter. They've got Tyrese Halliburton. They'll be topping out there with Benedict Mathurin. Then it's Isaiah Jackson. And it's Nembhard in at the two. Jackson gets the bucket.
There's a certain resiliency to this team, and you're starting to see it.
No doubt, keeping it very close, they're going to have to step up even more to get over the hump here.
Boston's gone 6-14 with the three ball tonight, just a little over 40%. Horford with a screen on Halliburton. Outside, Horford for the three. Good on the three-point shot.
Yeah, that's too good a look to give him from behind the arc.
And for the Pacers, they're shooting it really well. 54% from the floor. Now, Mathurin. And it's Jason Tatum with the foul. That'll be his second foul of the game. Celtics making a switch here. Holiday's checked in. The Pacers also with a sub. Jalen Smith, he's checked in for Jackson. ...60 seconds off the clock here in the fourth. And he lobs it up toward the rim. Outside for Halliburton. Yes, that goes in.
My goodness, what a dribble drive by Mr. Tyrese Halliburton.
Here's Holiday. Picked by Horford. From past the arc. It's good. The assist that time from Holiday. Holiday's got three assists now in this one.
Yeah, how about the percentage they're shooting from beyond the arc here in the second half?
Charity stripe shot. Almost, but it rolls out.
Normally he'll drill that shot, and I'm sure they'll look to find him in that spot again.
Well, no doubt. Very good play call, good execution. Sometimes it just doesn't fall.
Outside Holiday. It's rebounded by Indiana. Halliburton outside. Toppin sets a screen for Halliburton. Pass to Nembhard. And stolen by Horford. Pass to Pritchard. Back to Horford. Passes it to Tatum from outside the arc. It's rebounded by Indiana. Toppin's got six rebounds in the game.
Well, two long-range bombs in the first, but that's stalled out right now.
Halliburton passes to Smith. It's good from about 19 feet.
Halliburton's vision and then the ability to thread the needle there makes the defense pay.
Time called here. Timeout, the timeout. Celtics decide to talk it over.
Guarded.
And some changes here for the Celtics. Porzingis, he's checked in for Luke Kornet. Jaylen Brown comes in for Al Horford. And it's White in for Pritchard. And let's head over to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin, able to listen in on what Joe Mazzulla was going over with his team. He told them this is what it's all about, proving we're the better team in the tough situations. But you got to want it. Coach told his guys they have what it takes to win here. Guys, back to you.
Thanks so much, David. Brown finds White. Fourth quarter keeps moving right along. 3 minutes gone so far. The pass to Tatum from deep three-point territory. Boston, no good that time either.
And when you are as good a shooter as he is, you have to have the confidence to take that shot. It might not always fall.
And for most guys, I think you only want to take that shot if you hit a few in a row. That is absolutely a heat check.
Just five on the clock. 18 feet out. That one's in there. The Boston lead is cut to just 1 point on the basket from Siakam.
Pascal Siakam. Improvement, yes. Big time player, no doubt.
And here's Tatum for three. Drills it from outside.
That's one of those clutch shots he's known for. When the pressure is high, he seems to be the most locked in.
We've got 1:18 left to play in the final quarter. Turner with a screen on Halliburton. Here's Halliburton. It counts, and the foul. That one on White.
Fearless move by Tyrese Halliburton. The game is complete, and the mind is ready.
Let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for Boston.
And guys, how about the unselfishness and all about working that ball around, shifting the defense, and just seeking out the best shot?
And the other thing, guys, that they've been very effective at is shooting the long-range jumpers. The defense has been having trouble closing out to them in this game in particular. Well, this is why you run your offense through him in important situations. You know he's going to deliver.
Tatum against Siakam. Tatum, no good. And so Siakam will bring it up for the Pacers. They trail by one. Turner with a screen on Halliburton. Here's Halliburton. It's good!
And you can't get a bigger bucket than that.
I'll tell you, it takes confidence to pull the trigger in that situation. You love guys who relish the moment.
Outside Tatum.
Wow, Porzingis, no hesitation in the balance of the game. He delivers.
Timeout called, the Pacers. They're trailing by one. 36 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Holiday against Halliburton. We've got 28 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Feeds to Turner. Indiana needs to get a shot off. That's a two from heel. Ooh, offline. And they commit an intentional foul. We'll see another one of those so they can get into the penalty.
Yeah, you have to do that, though. You can't just let them dribble the game out.
11 seconds left in the fourth quarter, and now we've got the intentional foul. He hits the first one, and that will put them up by two.
And Holiday doesn't get easily rattled. He has a calm personality that helps him in big moments.
And he hits both free throws here. So now it's a three-point game.
Big-time free throws there. That could be the difference. It forces them now into a three-point attempt.
Timeout called the Pacers. They trail by three. There's 10 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Halliburton for three. Right between the eyes. A tremendous three to tie it up.
You see, Halliburton has the ability to rise above most defenders with the leg. Just puts it to great use there.
And so the timeout by Joe Mazzulla here. 8 seconds left to play here in the fourth. And here is Tatum. Oh, no good there. The potential game winner off the mark. And regulation now complete. We will go to overtime. We'll take a quick break, then get you back to the action. These teams have battled tooth and nail for four quarters, and now we head to overtime. Should be a blast.
Here we go.
The wing pairing, it's White and Brown. Jason Tatum is out there with Porzingis, and it's Holiday in at the point guard position. Tatum against Siakam. 6 on the shot clock. They find Jay on the way. The shot by Holiday, no good.
And they haven't been able to turn it into a big lead, but their rebounding advantage is starting to add up.
Heald, the pass to Nesmith. Holiday against Halliburton. And stolen by Tatum. Down low, here's White, and White with the stuff.
Yeah, the evolution of Tatum as a passer is evident. This guy more committed than ever to making the right play.
Overtime still getting started here, just about a minute in. Pass to Turner. Here's Halliburton, guarded by Holiday. They kick out to Heald. No good from outside. And here's Tatum. They'll bring it up for the Boston Celtics. And the officials will call the illegal screen right there.
Boy, that's the last thing they needed. This game too close to be making those kinds of errors.
Indiana's gotten a positive outcome on 7 of their 14 three-pointers in this game. Not bad at all. Holiday against Halliburton. He kicks it to Turner. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and 2 shots coming up. It's on Porzingis.
This is a very confident basketball player. Miles Turner wants to be in this spot. Now it's about knocking this one home.
The first, that narrows the gap to 1.
When it comes to shooting bigs, Turner's a good one, so this team likes having him in this spot.
And a tough break as his second attempt at the line, no good.
But the athleticism that Miles Turner brings to the center spot is quite remarkable. This guy, an exceptional player on both sides of the floor.
The shot's good from Halliburton.
Halliburton has the kind of personality that keeps him steady in big-time moments. How about that? Unfazed.
The Celtics have gone 1-3 from the floor since the start of overtime. Siakam against Tatum. Porzingis with a screen on Siakam. It drops. He has tied up this game. Oh, what a shot.
Unshakable trust in Jason Tatum in this sort of situation. Their staff just puts the ball in his hands and lets him make plays.
Turner with a screen on Holiday. Halliburton against Holiday. Clock at 4. Siakam passes to Halliburton. Now here is Holiday. Tatum wide open. He fires one. Tatum with another miss. Time call here. Indiana decides to chalk it over. Seconds left to play in OT, and this battle continuing. Halliburton against Holiday. Halliburton with it. Turner with a screen on Holiday. Halliburton for three. Bullseye!
And this is the game plan for him. He's a big part of their floor spacing.
And right now, Greg, he is doing a great job delivering for this team, productive and efficient.
Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. They're down by three. Just 2 seconds left in overtime. Guys, what's your take?
And they need a three to tie. But look, they've got enough time here to find a good look. They can run a play off the inbounds, make sure they get it in the hands of their best shooter.
A three from Tatum. Count it! And oh, that was an enormous three-pointer.
This guy can do so much for you on the offensive end, and that is why his number gets called time and time again.
And so the timeout here taken by Rick Carlisle. And so we are tied again at the end of overtime. Now we're headed to overtime number two. And we'll be back right after this. And as we play on into another overtime, you know these teams must be wearing down. It's become a battle of attrition. Here's Halliburton. On the wing, Turner, guarded by Porzingis. And Turner kicks to Halliburton. Wide open. A nice shot by Nesmith.
Well, good vision from the inside and kicking it to the perimeter.
And so Holiday will bring it up for the Boston Celtics. Inside, and White slams it in.
Savvy play from Holiday. Quick thinking helps him get the ball to the wide open man.
And so it's Indiana with it. Halliburton outside. Turner with a screen for Halliburton. On the wing, Turner. Siakam outside. Over Tatum. Siakam's shot is off.
Well, terrific defense. They obviously respect his ability and just want to make it tough.
And it's good. 2 points.
The very definition of their go-to player. Mr. Tatum, ball in your hands. Yes, sir.
Now Heal. Outside, Turner. Pass to Halliburton. Over Holiday. And it's Halliburton missing. The Celtics with the lead. The three from Tatum. And again, Boston with the triple.
When you allow Jason Tatum to get going early and to build momentum offensively, it can be a scary night.
To the middle to end the run. Second chance effort. Here's Turner. Throws it up off the glass.
Wow, Miles Turner understanding it's my time because it's big time.
Outside Tatum. Upside Brown. Baseline jumper. Good, and it's Tatum picking up the assist. And the Celtics lead by five.
Yeah, if you're going to be a franchise guy, you've got to want the ball in these clutch moments. Jaylen Brown doing work.
Halliburton for three. Jaylen Brown with the rebound.
And I thought that was going to drop. It looked good from here.
Tatum, that's good.
My goodness, Jason Tatum from another zip code.
And Indiana shooting an efficient 53% from the field. And the Pacers call time here.
Started.
They're behind by eight. There's 53 seconds left to play in the second overtime of quite a heated game. Halliburton against Holiday. Halliburton passes to Heald. Turner with a screen on White. Heald from outside. It counts. Oh, and that cuts the lead to just 5.
Buddy Heald, the opportunity to deliver in a big spot, and does just that.
And an intentional foul right there. So it's Boston now. Holiday, a screen on Siakam, and he commits the intentional foul. Drops the first one, and that increases their lead to 6.
From the moment Jason Tatum stepped into this league, he has been a guy who has wanted the burden offensively, and he has delivered.
And so both free throws are good, and it's a 7-point game.
And he adds to their lead with some very solid free throws.
Halliburton against Holiday.
That's just a savvy move to draw the foul. And despite that young age, Halliburton, like a seasoned veteran right there.
Shooting 2.
First free throw is good, and that turns the lead to 6.
What we know about Tyrese Halliburton, this guy always ready to push the pace. He's got a ton of energy. He's willing to outrun and outwork other guys.
And so he hits both. And here's Holiday. And so they foul intentionally. Good on the first, and that increases their lead to 6. He's off on the free throw, unable to get that second one to drop in. And here's Halliburton. He'll bring it up for Indiana. Porzingis with the block.
A swat by Porzingis. That wingspan letting you know he's in the house.
You have to foul, but I'm sure they would have liked to foul someone different.
He hits the first one, and that makes it a 7-point lead.
I think the thing that's most striking about Derek White, guys, he's capable of affecting games in so many ways. Yes, he can score it. Excellent passer and a very versatile cross-positional defender. A guy who can contribute to a good team.
Timeout call, the Pacers. They're trailing by 8. 16 seconds left in the second overtime period. Good stuff. Guys, your thoughts?
A lot to talk over and improve on for next time.
Well, maybe it could wait until after the game, because this one is over.
And it's the Pacers with the ball, trailing here by eight.
And they've been a different team here in overtime. They just seem to have lost their energy.
Now here is Holiday. So we see Boston get the win here. A double overtime game can really take its toll on the players. And after this one, the officials, the fans, everyone's going to have to take a needed rest.
No doubt. I mean, when you have to dig that deep and play with that much determination to get a win, it was earned. And I tell you what, they've got to feel really good about themselves for fighting through.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. KP, you guys got out on a break tonight. How did you get into transition so easily?
Yeah, we want to play faster, and that's what we try to do whenever they miss. We try to run, move the ball quick, and get easy buckets.
And you were able to beat them down the floor tonight, KP. Thanks a lot for your time. Kevin, back to you.
Thanks so much, David. And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, and the rest of our terrific crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. As we leave you with our New Balance Player of the Game, Jason Tatum.